Hey everybody, welcome back. So today we're going to be continuing with continuity. And what I want you to think about as we're going through this and the next couple of videos is we're really paralleling Calc 1. Okay, so we talked about limits last time. What did we do in Calc 1 after limits? We talked about this idea of continuity. Now back in Calc 1, continuity meant, at least visually, you can draw the graph without lifting up your pen, right? Which meant you didn't have holes, you didn't have jumps, and you didn't have vertical asymptotes or anything like that. Now, unfortunately, the parallel, or at least the Calc 3 way of doing continuity, it's going to be a little bit different because imagining the surfaces or the graphs of our functions is a lot harder. Okay, but we're going to see that our definition is very, very similar. So let's go ahead and review really quick. What did we have in Calc 1? So recall that we say a function is continuous at a point A provided the following three are satisfied. So f of A has to exist. So A is in the domain of your function. Two, the two-sided limit as x approaches a of f of x exists. Okay, so this means we don't have any jumps, we don't have any vertical asymptotes or anything. And then finally, three, the limit is actually equal to the function value. Okay, so some examples. Maybe we have something that looks like this. Okay, so here's a function, and notice it's continuous everywhere except for the origin here, because the origin we have this jump here. So it's continuous except at the origin. Actually, here, let's be a little bit more careful. At x equal to 0. Okay. Whereas if we think about the parabola, y equals x squared, this function is continuous everywhere. Now again, visually, we're not going to be able to think about continuity in the same way because our graphs are more complicated. And sometimes we can't even envision our graphs if we have a big multivariable function that has more than two variables. But in any case, we can define continuity in a very, very similar way. So we say a function is continuous at a point AB provided the following three hold. So first of all, AB has to be in the domain of f. The limit as xy approaches AB of f of x exists. And finally, three, the limit exists and is equal to the function value. Okay, so we say again, a function is continuous if these three things are defined, and again, or these three properties hold. And again, this is similar to what we had back in Calc 1, except now we're in a multivariable context. Okay, so let's talk about some properties. We still do have very, very nice properties of continuous functions that we had back in Calc 1. So let f and b, let and, I'm sorry, let f and g be two continuous functions. Okay, then the following hold. So if you multiply f by a scalar, you're still continuous. If you add or subtract your functions, you're still continuous. If you multiply your functions, you're still continuous. And if you divide your functions, you're continuous, provided you don't blow up the universe and divide by zero. Okay. A couple other things that I want to point out, which is going to give us some really, really nice results, is the function f of xy equal to x and f of xy equal to y. These are two functions that are continuous everywhere, are continuous everywhere. So we're also going to treat this as true as well. If you want, you can use the limit definition of the limit, I'm sorry, the epsilon delta definition of the limit to prove that, but take my word for it, these two functions, x and y, are continuous. Now, the reason why I bring this up is using this fact and the properties of continuity that we have here, we get the following nice result, which makes continuity arguments very, very simple. Well, quote unquote simple, at least nicer. So the following function families are continuous on their domain. Okay, so this means that as long as your point's in the domain, your function's continuous there. So polynomials and rational functions are both continuous on their domain. Now, Let's do a little bit of review. What is a polynomial? Polynomial is just anything that looks like this, like x times y plus 2, or x squared y cubed plus xy plus 3x squared plus 0. I don't know. These are, again, polynomials, and they are continuous everywhere on their domain. And what's nice about polynomials, remember, they are defined everywhere. They don't blow up or anything. They're really, really nice. So polynomials, continuous on their domains, which happen to be everywhere. Rational functions, these are quotients of polynomials, so things like x plus y over x minus y, or x squared plus y squared over 2xy. Okay, so these are continuous on their domain as well, although we have to be a little bit careful because rational functions could have more complicated domains than polynomials, so be careful with those. We also have similar results, but this doesn't really follow directly from the properties that we had earlier, but it's still nice to note. So multivariable functions with trig expressions in them are going to be continuous on their domain. Multivariable functions with exponentials are going to be continuous on their domain as well. And multivariable functions with logarithms are also going to be continuous as well. And just to give us some examples, trigonometric function, something like, I don't know, sine of x plus y, tangent of x plus 2y over x squared. Okay, things like that, they are continuous on their domain. Exponential functions, e to the x plus y, 2 to the x plus 3 to the y, let's say. Okay, those are going to be continuous on their domain. And remember, like polynomials, we're getting into pre-calc here, exponential functions have a domain that's all real numbers. Well, I'm sorry, all of R2. Okay. Unless you have weird things like e to the x over y, then we're going to run into some issues. But standard exponential functions are super nice. And finally, logarithmic functions, things like ln of x plus y. Let's get crazy. Log base 3. I don't know why that's crazy, but I don't know, something like this. These functions are also continuous on their domain. Okay. So if you can identify your function when you're trying to figure out where things are continuous, this can really, really help you. Okay. And be guided by domain. This is why we sort of make a stink about domain. We want you to be able to find domains, because if you know domain, you know continuity in a way. So let's look at some examples. So example one, determine where f of x, y is equal to x squared, y to the fourth minus 2xy plus 2 is continuous. So let's identify this function. Notice this is a polynomial. Okay. And like we saw in the previous slide, polynomials are continuous on their domains. And again, polynomials, super, super nice. Their domains are everything. So this function, f, is continuous on, in this case, since it's a polynomial, on all of R2. Okay, because polynomials have a domain, at least in the two-variable case of R2. Let's spice it up a little bit. Suppose we're dealing with 2xy over x minus y. So now we got a rational function. Okay, so this again is continuous on its domain, but we have to figure out what its domain is first. Okay, so what's the domain of this function? Well, notice we're dividing by x minus y, and what's the only number we can't divide by? Oops. And hopefully you've guessed it, it's 0. So the domain in this case would be all points x, y, such that x is not equal to y. Okay, and if we draw this graphically, it would be all of R2 except for the line going through the diagonal. Okay. Now, why is it x not equal to y? Again, if x was equal to y, we would be blowing up the universe there. Okay. So this function f is continuous at every x, y, except when x equals y. Because then we blow up. Let's look at one more example, and we'll call it a day. Determine where f of x, y is equal to x squared over x squared plus y squared when x, y is not 0, 0, and when it is 0, 0, it outputs 0. OK, Okay, so this is what we call a piecewise function. It's defined in pieces, in this case, two pieces. Okay, so how do we start this? Well, notice that when x, y is not 0, 0, okay, this function is really just x squared plus y squared. Now, what kind of function is that? That's a rational function. And remember, rational functions are continuous on their domain. Now, what's the domain of this rational function? Well, it happens to be every point x, y, except for the origin. So since this rational function is continuous at every point in its domain, that makes f continuous on all points x, y that aren't 0, 0. Okay. This doesn't mean, though, that it's not continuous at 0, 0, or it is continuous at 0, 0. We got to do a little bit more work, though. Okay. So we need to test, or we need to examine 0, 0 more closely. Okay, we get everything else for free because when x, y is not 0, 0, it's that rational function. But at 0, 0, how do we know if it's continuous there? Well, we don't know. Let's check. Okay. So remember the definition of continuity first. F of 0, 0 would need to be defined. Now, is it defined? Absolutely. It's defined to be 0. So we're good there. Check. Second condition, we need the limit as x, y approaches 0, 0 to exist. Okay. All right, so let's see if it exists. Okay. Now, remember, with the limit definition, remember, we're not actually plugging in the point 0, 0, right? We're plugging everything that's around it. So this limit is really just the limit of that rational function you see. X squared over x squared plus y squared. Okay? So notice we can't plug in 0, 0 because we'd be blowing up the universe. So we can't use that direct substitution property. And let's go ahead and try some paths. Okay, so if we travel along, let's say x equal to 0, okay, this limit goes to 0 over y squared, which is 0. Okay? If we travel along y equal to 0, the limit would go to x squared over x squared, which is 1. Okay. So notice we traveled along two different paths. We got two different limits here. So we would conclude that this does not exist. And so what does that mean for us in our continuity? It would mean that this function is not continuous at 0, 0. So in summation, f is continuous at all x, y, except for 0, 0.